Well, you know, it's like from the very beginning, I knew, you know, we need visual effects. And what you don't want to have in a war movie, you know, that the visual effects take you out of the movie. When you have like sometimes, you know, some fantasy or science fiction movie, everybody knows it's fake. But here in Midway, it had to look absolutely real. And I think the two houses we used, they really felt that responsibility too. So, and you know, and it was not an easy task, but at the end, you know, I think we accomplished it.
Well, I play Lieutenant Clarence Earl Dickinson, and he's one of the many brave heroes and dive bombers during Midway. There were very few of them, and he plays alongside Ed's character, Dick Best, and they're kind of best buddies in the film. They're kind of the goose to maverick relationship. And yeah, he was an amazing man. He was the first naval hero to ever receive 3 naval crosses. He retired in the Navy as a rear admiral, and he died in 1984, and he was a true hero, paved the way for us. I think my most favorable moment was getting to work with these two guys. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I must say on Luke's character, Clarence Dickinson, we could have made the movie about him. Yeah. And that's what was so amazing about this. You know, not to go off on a tangent, but the more I researched into it, the more accounts that I read, the more I saw these incredible stories of bravery and heroics and how many individual heroes there were in these battles. And that's just specifically on the carriers involved in the Battle of Midway. All over the war, there were these incredible stories of bravery. And in this movie, there's about 10 characters that could have been the lead characters. So, you know, there's so many heroes in this, in the greatest generation. My most memorable, I mean, the whole shoot was just incredibly memorable. I suppose shooting on Ford Island, Pearl Harbor, Hickam Air Base in Oahu, Hawaii, I mean, that was just an incredible experience. Sometimes we'd be out there with, what, 350 extras and 200 people behind the camera. And, you know, sometimes when you're in the business of cinema and making movies, you stand on set and you think, if people really saw what making movies were like, they would realize it's very different from what they imagine. But when you're on a Roland Emmerich set in Pearl Harbor, it's exactly how you would imagine it. It is the sort of epic, huge scale, the sort of glamour of cinema. Everyone's dressed up in all these amazing costumes. It's kind of like a Where's Waldo scene with everyone running around and, you know, the period wheelchairs and trucks and vans and planes and everything. It was incredible, and it was many moments where I'd pinch myself and think, wow, this is epic.
Well, for me, it's like actually, you know, it's look at all the action scenes and stuff, that's like what I'm used to. So for me, I'm always looking forward to the more silent, the more calmer sequences. And that was like the amazing thing about the script. It had a lot of these, you know, more, you know, like kind of measured, you know, where you like delve into the characters, and when you show that these people were really afraid what they were doing and felt at that time the responsibility, because that's what we found out in our research, that these people were not, when you like kind of read their books, you know, not that gung-ho about, you know, what they were doing, and they were not so sure if they can do it.